increase their protein. How do you think you could increase your protein?
What does increase mean?
It means add more.
Eat protein every single day.
There you go. Leave me a comment. I am new. I would love to connect with you. And if you have any questions or need help regarding your health and fitness journey, please, I would be honored to help you. So just again, leave your comments and questions. Everything you guys will be in the show notes. So anything I talk about, any links, any freebies I have, my websites, my social media, everything I talk about in this video will be in the show notes. So check those out. Don't forget, you guys, to give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down, whatever you fancy. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit that little notification bell so you will be notified when I do upload new videos. Other than that, you guys, today is a really quick video and it's regarding nutrition, okay? Because something I get asked a lot, this is kind of what I'm an expert in, is macro coaching and things like that. So one of the things that from my recent videos I've been getting tons of DMs and emails about is being scared to eat the calories and the macros that were provided from the macronutrient calculator. And the second one is protein. Like, how the heck can I eat that much protein? I've never ate that much protein before. So today's video, you guys, I'm just gonna give you my simple tips on how to increase your protein intake. Again, if you've never tracked your macros and things like that, that obviously is my number one first tip for increasing your protein intake. You need to know your macros and you need to have a modality to track it on. So I use MyFitnessPal, I love it. I do the premium feature so I can set it up for setting up my macros. So it can show me, you know, how many macros each I have left in the day. My second tip for you would be to input your food the night before or follow a meal plan, because then you know that it's been made to hit those macros every day. So you don't have to worry about that each and every day. If you're like, oh, I haven't made my macros or I haven't reached my protein intake, you're not scrambling at the end of the night. So that would be kind of the foundational, would be to track your macros, pre-make your meals in MyFitnessPal the night before so that you know that you're gonna be hitting your macros. And same thing with if you're following a meal plan, it's already done custom to you and to your macros, so you don't have to worry. All you have to do is follow those meals. But another obvious thing too is if you are kind of just winging it, number one thing that really helped me increase my protein intake was protein powders, so whey and things like that, because you know sometimes it's hard to eat all that chicken at once or fish or things like that. Fish is actually really high in protein, so if you do like fish, that's an awesome thing to add to your meals, because it has like anywhere from 40 to 50 grams of protein per like fillet. So that's a really good way to increase your protein, but whey is probably the number one thing that I use a lot. I have it in my breakfast, sometimes for post-workout. And then if I have a little bit of protein left at night, like let's say I have like 30 grams still, I'll have a protein shake before bed. So whey is inexpensive way to increase your protein intake. So those would kind of be my tips for you to help you increase your protein. First, start tracking your macros, inputting it the night before, so that you know where you are, where you're needing more protein. Try to prioritize protein in all your meals and snacks. Have a little bit of protein always. First, you should always have your calories prioritized. That being said, that meaning if you're wanting to be in a deficit, your calories are always prioritized. Same with being in a surplus. And then second comes your proteins. So calories, protein, prioritize, and then your carbs and your fats can kind of fit in there however you have your macros balanced. But calories, if you're in deficit, you need especially to make sure you stay within those calories if you're trying to lose weight. Oh wow, thank you, I got some tea. Oh, thank you.
It's water. Oh. Daddy won't let me have it. Can I?
Yes, you can. No, yeah, I'll help you after, okay? Well, we're just gonna have, is this protein water? We're doing a protein video right now. I'm trying to teach the ladies how to increase their protein. How do you think you could increase your protein?
What does increase mean?
It means add more.
Eat protein every single day.
So that would be, so I'm just going to quickly recap you guys for this, for making sure you're hitting your protein, would be to track it on MyFitnessPal. First, know your macros. You can go to my website, hannahdawson.ca. You'll see that at the top, in recipes. If you click on recipes, there's macronutrient calculator or carb cycling. You can choose. I'll put the links in below. So figure out what your macros need to be, then prioritize, you know, your protein in each meal. So when you go to MyFitnessPal, just making sure that you're adding protein to each meal, and things like that. I go more into detail. Like, I have a whole course, you guys, Macros to Muscle, where I teach you exactly what macronutrients are, what yours need to be, how to track your, like, everything. I go into detail what carb cycling is, what flexible dieting is, how you can apply it. You get all the tools there. So that's going to be launching at the end of November. So I will keep you guys updated with videos. But those are my first tips. Track your macros, get your macros, put it into MyFitnessPal the night before. And again, if you're low, if you seem like you can't get enough protein, whey is one of your best options to add extra protein in, because you can always add 2 scoops post-workout to increase that protein, or a scoop and a half really helps increase that protein and stuff like that. So those would be my tips. I hope this was helpful. Again, give me a thumbs up, leave your comments below this video, share this with somebody that you know may help. Again, you guys, I love you all. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you are happy, healthy, and safe wherever you are, and I will see you guys soon. Bye.